Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Eshwar Chandrasekharan. Today I'll be presenting my work titled The Bag of Communities, Identifying Abusive Behavior Online with Preexisting Internet Data. I'd like to begin by thanking my co-authors, Mattia, Samory, Anirudh, Srinivasan, and my advisor, Eric Gilbert, for their help. A key challenge for online communities is moderating abusive behavior. Since its earliest days, harassment and abuse have plagued the internet. According to a recent survey by Pew Research, approximately 40% of internet users have reported being the subject of online abuse at some point of time. In the following slide, I'll be showing examples of real threats and comments posted on the internet. Please watch out for explicit content. Abusive behavior and norm violations can be difficult to define precisely, but as the saying goes, you know it when you see it. For the purpose of this work, abuse is an omnibus term including harassment, threats, racial slurs, sexism, and insults. All of these can be directed at users or at whole communities. Due to the overwhelming nature of abusive content that gets generated in the comment sections, well-known websites have shut down comment sections on their site. To name a few, the sites like Verge, the National Public Radio, and CNN have shut off their comment sections in the last few years. But this is moving away from people having a voice on the internet, which is not the best direction to head in. Given that online abuse is such a widespread problem on the internet, where several online communities are already struggling with, do we really have to start from scratch? Current work tends to focus on site-specific solutions. For example, Facebook tries to solve Facebook's own abuse detection problem, and Twitter solves it for Twitter. Our idea is to use cross-community similarity to detect abuse. Here's an illustration of what we propose. When new and unlabeled posts are generated within a community, similarity scores can be assigned by comparing them to pre-existing posts from other online communities. In this example, RScience and 4chan. Depending on how similar a post is to content from either of these communities, a downstream classifier could use these similarity scores to make predictions about abusive behavior. To give an idea of the type of abuse that we are dealing with, I will show some comments that were moderated from a certain online community. I'll provide more information about where these comments exactly come from in a bit. But for each of these examples, we find the presence of multiple similar comments which are naturally occurring within other online communities. These provide the intuition behind our cross-community similarity approach to detect online abuse. Please note that the following slide will also include examples of abusive content which might be offensive. To begin with, here's an abusive comment that was removed by human moderators for violating their abuse policies. Turns out this commenter isn't as original as they thought. Users post such things all over the time on 4chan. For instance, we found several comments that contain highly similar abuses on 4chan's B and poll boards, which were still present online. Next is another example that gets moderated from this online community. As you can tell, it's highly racist and hateful. Again, we found there were several examples of these on other sites. For instance, such comments are characteristic of the content prevalent on this specific racist forum on Voat. In addition to the presence of highly similar content on abusive online communities, we also find stark differences with the type of content generated within well-moderated communities. For instance, the type of language used in comments within a well-moderated subreddit like Ask Historians is uncharacteristic of abuse that we see which gets moderated. Therefore, similarities and dissimilarities to content from prototypical online communities could be used to detect such behaviors. These examples show the intuition behind our approach to detect online abuse in this work. When new and unlabeled posts are generated in a target community, similarity scores can be assigned by comparing them to pre-existing posts from a bag of source communities. We call this cross-community similarity, or CCS. In our work, we learn about online abuse from 9 unique sources and apply it on a completely different target community. We showed that abuse can be detected by using publicly available data from other online communities which are neither moderated nor labeled. We call this approach the bag of communities, analogous to the well-known bag of words representation. The bag of communities' goal is to develop a function that maps similarities to large-scale internet data from source communities to predictions in a target community. In particular, cross-community similarity allows online communities to piggyback on the data of others, requiring far fewer and perhaps no labeled training examples. In this paper, we present an existence proof by applying bag of communities to detect online abuse in our target community. We build cross-community similarities for 9 source communities with close to 10 million posts. A downstream bag of communities classifier uses site-specific information along with these internal CCS estimations from 4chan, MetaFilter, and Voat, and so on, to predict likelihood of unseen posts being labeled as offensive. We tested our bag of communities by making predictions on 200,000 unseen moderated posts from a separate target community. Our bag of communities approach addresses some of the key challenges faced by research in this domain. For instance, new and emerging online communities lack enough data from their respective users and also lack the resources to build abuse detection models. As a result, they are unable to build detection systems during their initial or formative stages. This is also known as the cold start problem. And through our work, we show that they don't have to reinvent the wheel from scratch every time someone new is dealing with online abuse. BOC does this by relaxing the need for ground truth, which is labeled for abuse, including a range of data sources. A related challenge is the restricted access to moderated content. Sites don't publicly share moderated data due to privacy and PR concerns. As a result, research tends to be around in-domain approaches to detect abuse, and site developers use site-specific models to catch abusive behavior. In order to evaluate our approach, we tested our classifiers on data obtained from a target community. It's a community you all know, but we can't tell you which one exactly. They gave us their data despite the PR concerns surrounding the sharing of such moderated data. In exchange for their graciousness, we offered to not associate their name with the abusive content. I will refer to this community by the pseudonym Mixed Bag as per our research agreement. We were given the text contained in 200,000 moderated comments which were removed off the site. These were generated over 4 years and removed off-site by human moderators for violating site abuse policies. For pre-existing examples of abuse, we looked at source communities where naturally occurring content resembles offensive content we see on Mixed Bag. For prototypical examples of abuse, we used posts from 4chan's B and poll boards. These boards are infamous for exhibiting a range of explicit content. The use of racist, sexist, and homophobic language is common on these 4chan boards. In addition to 4chan, we collected data from the subreddits Fat People Hate and Coontown. These subs were notorious for engaging in fat shaming and racism, and they were subsequently banned by Reddit in 2015. Following the banning of these hateful subs, alternatives came into existence on Voat.co. We also obtained data from these Voat equivalents, which engage in fat shaming and racism too. We had a hunch that data from these sources would be useful to detect abuse through cross-community similarities. For pre-existing examples of non-abuse, we gathered content from well-moderated communities. For instance, MetaFilter is a link-sharing community with a $5 registration fee per account, which creates a barrier to entry. Also, MetaFilter is heavily moderated and accounts are banned for violations. We also get data from well-moderated subreddits like Ask Science, Ask Historians, and Neutral Politics. These forums have clear regulation policies that are strictly enforced by an active set of moderators. We had a hunch that data from these sources would be useful to contrast with the kind of abuse that we see. Using close to 10 million unannotated and unmoderated comments from these 9 source communities, we built our bag of communities model. Using similarities to data from these source communities, we made predictions on 200,000 unseen moderated posts from a completely different target community, Mixed Bag. Next, I'll quickly talk about the CCS estimators and how they were constructed for each of these 9 source communities. In the first step, the data undergoes standard pre-processing. And the next step, we balance the data sets and build a bag of words model. In the final step, these features are used to build 3 classifiers. We perform a grid search on a parameter space and found that naive-based gave the best performance. So all future references to models would be a naive-based classifier. Overall, cross-community similarity is measured as the likelihood of an unseen post belonging to a source community, which is returned by these classifiers. Using these CCS estimators, we built 2 different models to detect abusive content in Mixed Bag, BOC static and BOC dynamic. The BOC static only trains the underlying CCS estimators for these 9 source communities, and it has no access to data from the target community. The second is a dynamic or online learning model, which is iteratively trained on increasing number of moderated posts from a target community. It's an extension of BOC static and mimics what an upstart community might face when building its own abuse detection models as new moderated labels come in over time. While the BOC static represents a pre-trained model that can be deployed off the shelf to identify online abusive content. We compared the accuracy obtained by our BOC static model to three baseline classifiers when detecting online abuse in mixed bag. First is a blacklist, which resembles a commonly deployed approach used on most sites. It's based on a word list containing offensive terms, and this list was obtained from a prior work on word list bans. The next is the one-class SVM, which is trained purely on unmoderated comments obtained from a mixed bag. Hence, it resembles a outlier detection, a model classifying posts it has not seen before as being abusive. Third is chance, which resembles a random classifier. And in our case, since the data sets are balanced, we get close to 50% accuracy. Overall, we found that the BOC static gave an accuracy of 75.3% when seeing no data from the target community and outperforming all our baselines. Next, we look at the dynamic models we built. The in-domain is a classifier built entirely using mixed bag data, and it does not have any access to any of the bag of communities data points. And the BOC dynamic is a classifier built using CCS estimations from the source communities, 4chan, MetaFilter, and so on, present in our bag of communities. We examined the improvements in accuracy that were gained when increasing amounts of test samples were shown to these dynamic learning models. When zero test samples are seen, the BOC models give close to 75% accuracy when the purely in-domain model starts at 50%. From that point onwards, at every stage, the BOC continues to do better than the purely in-domain model. In the final iteration, they were all shown 100,000 moderated examples and tested on the remaining unseen data. We found that the BOC dynamic model gave the best performing accuracy of 91.18% with a precision of 95%. This high precision achieved by BOC is an advantage. Through informal talks with community moderators, we learned that they would prefer precision-centric models that can triage abusive contents with as much accuracy as possible. Another advantage of BOC dynamic model is that it can learn more site-specific information from the moderated comments that it sees over time. For instance, if there's a level of tolerance that is different from what you observe in the static model, it could learn that over time. Overall, we found that the BOC dynamic model outperforms the solely in-domain model with access to over 4 years of moderated content from the target community. I would like to conclude by talking about some of the implications of our work. We introduced a novel computational approach to detect online abuse called Bag of Communities, which addresses some of the challenges faced by research in this domain. We presented an existence proof showing that it is possible to detect online abuse using unmoderated and unannotated data. Our results indicate that there is no need to start from scratch every time when we start building detection systems. A potential implication for new online communities is that our BOC model can be used off the shelf to detect online abuse and thereby help emerging online communities without enough resources. While the implication for old online communities is that even on established sites with years of professional moderation, our BOC dynamic model can continually boost abuse detection systems. In our future work, we plan to extend our bag of communities to other source and target communities. For instance, if we can get access to every subreddit that's present on Reddit, we could include similarity estimations for each of them. Our current work is the first step indicating that it's profitable to piggyback on the data of others when building abuse detection models. We plan to make our models public, and our current code and CCS estimators for 4chan can be found at this URL. We hope that researchers can easily use them in their work as we plan to extend our models to multiple source and target communities in the future. With that, I conclude my talk. Thank you all for being here, and I can take questions.
Paul Resnick from Michigan. You showed better accuracy with your system than various baselines. Do you have a sense of for which tasks the accuracy that you achieved is good enough? So how good is good enough accuracy?
Okay. The question was how do we try and estimate whether the performance that we achieve is good enough? The commonly deployed approaches that we learned from our source community moderators is that they use these blacklist terms to identify comments that have abuses, but that's not going to identify a wider range of abuse that you see. They will be restricted to the static word list that you actually see on your site. So when beginning with an off-the-shelf model, which is our static model, we get a 75% accuracy, meaning that it can catch 3/4 of the content that it sees. I think that's a good enough start when you have no grounding from the target community and you're going in blind. But that's not like an ideal model that you would like release publicly or you would use automatically. So the findings that we show that indicate that it can be used to help triage comments in the earlier stages and maybe like have a human in the loop, which would result in a safer automated system that can be released publicly.
Thank you.
So, you know the saying, happy families are happy the same, and unhappy families are unhappy in their own way. So I'm wondering if one of the implications of this work is that online communities are dysfunctional in the same ways. Like, do you think that this suggests that harassment is all kind of similar? Like, how much of a sense of that do you get from the findings from this work?
Okay, yeah. So the intuition with which we began this is that the most of the abuse that we see on these sites, it resembled what we actually saw on some boards in 4chan. So that was the intuition or the initial spark that led to us to look at these communities. But yeah, as you put it, we could think of it that most of what everyone comes up with, someone's already said it online. So yes, our idea is that some of these abuses which harm most of these communities tend to be similar across different lines. There could be different nuances to it, but overall, when they are directed at individuals and meant to harm each other, I think, yeah, there is enough examples out there that we could learn about.